This is a flight model comparison between the old and new FA-18C Hornet flight model in Carrier Landing HD. Let's dive right into it. Right off the bat, I have a smoother takeoff. When I change the flap setting from half to auto, I don't get a sudden pitch down anymore. This is an improvement in controllability. At sea level, the top speed of the old FA-18C flight model is 766 knots indicated airspeed. With the new flight model, it's 682 knots, so it's slower. Now at higher altitude, at 36,000 feet, my top speed actually increases from 521 knots indicated airspeed to 552 knots indicated airspeed. That's Mach 1.67 to 1.77 in Mach speed terms. Now let's go on to the Immelmann and Split S. I observe higher alphas in the Immelmann and Split S. I can pull around 40 to 50 degree AOA in the new one versus like 30 to 40 in the old one. And when I do the Split S maneuver, I have between 400 to 500 more feet to spare. And this is an example of a carrier landing with the old and new FA-18C flight models. Perfect carrier landings are now slightly easier. From these maneuvers, we can definitely conclude that there are now smoother changes in lift coefficient when changing between flap settings. We have significantly improved controllability for the FA-18C Hornet, and this definitely dispels the misconception that physics of CLHD are not suitable for a phone, which is a claim that I think Phil said, the developer of Gunship 4. The FA-18C's top speed and possibly acceleration have improved, especially at high altitudes. Clearly, the plane is more maneuverable in one circles now because of the improved angle of attack. This also shows that the FA-18C's angle of attack was understated not only in DCS world, but also in Carrier Landing HD. As I said before, carrier landings are now easier. Thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.